This is part four of solving a quadratic equation using the quadratic formula right here. And we're going to solve this equation using the quadratic formula and also by factoring. The first thing we want to do with this is simplify each side so we can get it into standard form. So we need to do the distributive property. 7x times x is 7x squared. Minus 7x times 2 is 14x plus 2x plus 8. And let's go ahead and subtract 3 from both sides so that we have it equal to 0. So let's see if we combine like terms here. We have 7x squared minus 12x plus 5 equals 0. Now, to be honest, if you're trying to solve a quadratic equation, and if you can factor it, that's going to be usually the quickest way to do it. So let's go ahead and do this by factoring. See if it factors. The only possibilities here could be 7x and x for the first terms. And the only possibilities here could be 5 and 1. So the question is, where would the 5 go and where would the 1 go? Let's see. If I do 5 here, 1 there, both minus, that's the correct factorization. If you multiply that back out, you'll get back to 7x squared minus 12x plus 5 equals 0. So then we could just set each factor equal to 0 and solve. Divide both sides by 7. So we got x equals 5 sevenths. And then we'll do this other one, x minus 1 equals 0, so x equals 1. So that's the other solution. And of course, the only way you know for sure these are correct is you would have to plug each back in the original equation right here, one at a time. And that's not so awful to do, but yeah, you're going to have to deal with getting common denominators, etc., to add inside the parentheses and be very careful with fractions, at least for the 5/7. One, it'll be easy to check. Okay, so let's now do the problem using the quadratic formula. So remember, we got 5/7 and 1. All right, so this was our original problem. When we did it by factoring, we got 5/7 and 1. When we simplified and put it in standard form, we had 7x squared minus 12x plus 5. So if we're going to use the quadratic formula, these are our values for a, b, and c. Now, instead of plugging them in directly, I'm going to go ahead and figure out what b squared minus 4ac is, so I know what's going to go underneath that radical. So I'm going to have b squared. Well, if b is negative 12, b squared will be negative 12 times negative 12, 144, minus, and it says 4ac, so it's going to be 4 times ac. That's 7 times 5, which is 35. So that's 144. Remember, you do multiplication over here first before you subtract. So 4 times 35 is 140. And so that's 4. So what this does is when you're going to put it in the quadratic formula now, you know that you're going to have the square root of 4. Remember, it's the b squared minus 4ac that goes underneath the radical. So we've got fraction bar. All right, so the quadratic formula says the opposite of b. All right, so if b is negative 12, you're going to do the opposite of b. So it's 12 plus or minus the square root of 4, right? Square root of this number right here, right? So what's the square root of 4? 2. All over 2a. All right, well, what's a? 7, so it's over 14. So I'm showing just sort of a little bit of a shortcut here instead of having to write everything out, which it's also good to be able to do that. All right, so this gives me two solutions here. 12 plus 2 over 14. And 12 minus 2 over 14. All right, so 12 plus 2 over 14, what's that? That's 14 over 14, or 1. And what's 12 minus 2 over 14? That's 10 14ths, which reduces to 5 sevenths. So notice I got the same answers, 1 and 5 sevenths. All right, let's just do this problem one more time where we don't do anything on our head. We show everything, all the steps, and then you've got your choice. What's easier for you? That's really key. All right, here's the original problem after we simplified it. Here's the values of A, B, and C. Here's the quadratic formula. And here you can see where I'm plugging in the values of A, B, and C into the quadratic formula. So where there's a B, I'm putting in negative 12. Where there's an A, I'm putting in 7. And where there's a C, I'm putting in 5. All right, so this is what it would look like. And then we would simplify that. So opposite of negative 12 is 12. And then you would just simplify underneath the radical at this point. It's still going to be 144 minus 140 over 14. So it's going to be 12 plus or minus square root of 4 over 14, which is 12 plus or minus 2 over 14. And there are your two different solutions you're going to get, just like we did it the other way. From here, it looks exactly the same. 12 plus 2 over 14, or 12 minus 2 over 14. So you're going to get 14 over 14, or 1, or 10 over 14, which is 5 sevenths. So you're going to get your solution either way. Let's go ahead and check 1, since that's the easy one, into the original equation. Okay, why don't you put the video on pause and try it on your own first. Okay, here we go. We're going to plug in 1 for x. So I have 7 times 1 times 1 minus 2 plus 2 times 1 plus 4. Okay, see, so I'm plugging in the 1, and so I have 7 times 1, that's 7, and 1 minus 2 is negative 1, plus 2 times 5, so I have negative 7 plus 10, or 3. Left side's 3, right side's 3, and it checks. I think I can get the check for the next one in here, so let's go ahead and check 5 sevenths too. All right, so we're going to check 5 sevenths. It's good practice for you to try plugging in 5 sevenths on your own and seeing if this left side simplifies to 3. This is just practice with fractions here. All right, so I'm plugging in 5 sevenths everywhere there is an x, and inside parentheses I'm going to have to subtract, so I need a common denominator. So that's why I wrote 2 is 2 over 1, so I'm going to multiply top and bottom here by 7 over 7. And same thing in the second parentheses, 7 over 7, so that my simplification is going to be a little bit easier. Okay, now, I have 7 times 5 sevenths. I can go ahead and cancel those 7s so that I have 5 times, and then what's inside parentheses? What's this going to be? I've got a common denominator of 7, so I have 5 minus 14, which is negative 9, right? So I've got negative 9 sevenths plus 2 times, right, what do I have over here? I've got sevenths, and I've got 5 plus 28, I think that's 33. All right, so I have 5 times negative 9 sevenths, that's negative 45 sevenths plus 66 sevenths, because that's 2 times 33, and then I have to do 66 minus 45, that's 21 sevenths. Woohoo! 21 sevenths is 3. So you know what? Wasn't so bad after all. It checked, so we are now certain that our solutions, both of them checked, are 1 and 5 sevenths. Really, this puts a lot of what you learn in elementary algebra and intermediate algebra together, because you are solving equations, you're working with fractions, you could be factoring, all sorts of things. Just practice, practice, practice.